Hello guys, this is Rahul Dhawan. So welcome to my channel. So today we are going to start our new series in which we will be learning every day new thing in machine learning. So today is day one of ML. So I think you guys are ready, very exciting to start this thing. So today we will be going to look at naive-Bayes' ML algorithm. So what is naive-Bayes actually? So it's actually a supervised machine learning algorithm. So when I said supervised, I mean we will have a labeled data with us and features are also available. So that's actually supervised. So it is actually going to be used only in classification kind of problem, and it will be going to use the principle of Bayes theory. So suppose you guys are a data analyst in some bank and they said you have to predict if a customer is going to pay his loan fully or they will be in the defaulter list. So you will be going to think of this algorithm, but you will be thinking like, why it is called as naive? Is it that naive or dumb? But answer is no, it's actually a good algorithm than other algorithms. Complicated algorithm, we can say. Why it's called naive is because all the features that we are going to use in it, it assumes that they are independent of each others. So, and why Bayes? Because it is going to use principle of Bayes theorem. And so we need to first understand what is Bayes theorem then. So Bayes theorem actually use the principle, again, principle of conditional probability. So what is actually conditional probability? So conditional probability actually means like, if you are given an instance with you and you want to find a probability of other instance that is dependent on the previous instance, so that will be actually a conditional probability. Suppose you have a deck of cards, so 52 cards in it, and so suppose you want to draw one card, so first probability will be 1/13, and another will be like for same card, so for the same color of card, you will have the probability 1/12 because it is dependent on other last instance, because you already draw one card, so 13 minus 1/12 is 1/12. So that's actually conditional probability. So it is given by this formula P, probability of theta, given that D instance is already done, so we called it as posterior probability, is equal to P of theta, prior probability of theta, like only theta is true, into P of D, given theta is true, so that is likelihood of D, divided by probability of D is true. So this is actually a basic formula for calculating the probability. And one more thing is, when we are going to implement this thing, it will be going to give us only the probabilities, not just a classes. So based on that probability, we'll be going to decide whether it belongs to this class or that class. So yes, so we will go into the next page. Okay, so this is actually a live example. Suppose you are working in that bank and bank gave you this data. So this is already provided to bank. Like, if the credit score is between 100 to 100, four didn't provide the loan and six gave the loan. So this is kind of the data with you. So suppose they want to know like a person with a credit score of 180, is it in default list or not? So for that, what we need to do is, firstly we will calculate the prior probability, step one. Like, so if you don't remember the formula, you can just pause and see the formula again. So first thing is like prior probability, so we will calculate the prior probability of each class, so that is p of s will be 6 and divided by P of S will be 6 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1, that's 11 by 29 the total. So that's, and P of 100 to 200 is like both will come 6 plus 4 10, and 10 divided by 29. So we have probability with us. Now the next step is given, we want to calculate conditional probability 100 to 100 given it is in default list. So that is 6, and we are only considering here yes. So 6 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1, so that's 11. We are not considering no, so that's why 29 changes to 11. So 6 by 11, so that's actually conditional probability. So now the final thing, if it is, so we will calculate the probability of one class and other class will be 1 minus of that, because we know the sum of each outcome, probability of each outcome will be 1. So we will calculate P of yes given it is between 100 to 200, as we know it's 180. So for that, the formula we know is like P of 100 to 200 given yes into P of yes divided by P of 100 to 200. So we know this prior probability and we calculate this likelihood. So just fit in into this formula and we will get the result as 0.599. Now the last step is make a prediction. So when we said make a prediction, it means based on that probability we will decide. So general rule is basically what we use in the outside world is like, if it is greater than 0.5, that means if it is 50% greater than 50%, then we will say it's true, like it's in yes. Otherwise it's in no, so it is like greater than this. So if it is in the default list, actually it will, the credit score is 180. So this is the basic understanding of name base. You can apply it in anywhere, like wherever the classification problem is there. So in the next video, coming video, we will be going to implement it from in Python from the first step to last step. So thank you.